Nigel Farage announced his political comeback yesterday, vowing to take on the Tories himself as a Reform Party candidate in July's general election. The television presenter and Brexiteer also reclaimed his leadership of the right-wing Eurosceptic Reform Party, who have been giving the Conservative Party trouble ever since their founding in 2018 as the Brexit Party. Former Brexit Party member of the European Parliament and current broadcaster Alex Phillips joins me now. Alex, a lot of media headlines claim this is a shock announcement from Farage. Were you surprised or did you see this coming?
Well, do you know what? I've got a bit of an inside track on this because the party had actually asked me at one point to stand in Clacton, and I'd been having conversations with Nigel about it and then decided against it, actually, because I need to focus on my broadcasting career. And I knew that Nigel had always been in two minds about whether to stand or not. And I always knew that he was looking at Clacton as the potential seat because of the favourability of standing there. So it doesn't surprise me, actually. He's been out on the campaign trail, knowing him like I do. He'd have got this great sense of uplift from all the people saying, please stand, watching the polls begin to move. And he just can't resist the fight. It'd be very difficult for him, I think, to sit on the sidelines and potentially see other people elected and him not.
Well, the bulk of the media loves to give Nigel a terrible time. They love to hate him, but what he's been able to achieve, the success that he had with Brexit, one could argue he is the most consequential British politician we've seen since Thatcher. What can he realistically achieve, though, in the general election with such a short campaign period?
Yeah, you know, it's so difficult to call, especially under first past the post, which just doesn't favour small parties. But, you know, when we've had a resurgent UKIP, a resurgent Brexit Party, other political outfits that he led into general elections, at the same time we had a Conservative Party that was also strong and voters who were attracted to those right-wing policies, and Nigel's presence would almost make the Conservatives then ape what he was saying to the voters, and the voter would go, well, do you know what, because it's the bigger party, the legacy party, I'm going to put my vote there. What's happened is the Conservatives have not delivered. And so this time round, you've got a resurgent reform with the Conservatives' backs against the ropes. So it'll be interesting to see now whether he can actually tip it over the top and get seats in the Parliament.